We're just 1 week away from Election Day. Our CBS News battleground tracker shows former Vice President Joe Biden maintaining his lead over President Trump. CBS News' current estimate has Biden leading in states worth 279 electoral votes to President Trump's 163. On election night, CBS News Elections and Surveys Director Anthony Salvanto, also known as the other Anthony at CBS, will be looking at all the data to decide when and how to project the winner of each state. He joins us now. Good morning. Boy, Anthony, do I not envy you your job this year. But your election team, you've examined every state with the battleground tracker. And so take us through each candidate's path to 270 electoral votes needed to win the presidency.
Sure thing. Good morning, Anthony. So let me show you a map and tell you a story. The states on here, although they're leaning in red, are leaning towards the president. And the ones in blue are leaning towards Joe Biden. The ones in white are pure toss-ups. Now, I want you to look at the Sun Belt and the Upper Midwest, or the Rust Belt. There's a surprising number of toss-up and close states in the Sun Belt this year. Arizona, which the president won last time, Florida, which is always a battleground, Georgia, North Carolina, all of them may be surprisingly in play, and then the Upper Midwest, where you've got a bunch of states leaning towards Joe Biden. So what does each candidate need to do? Well, Joe Biden needs to hang on to what's already leaning his way. Maybe easier said than done, because he's still got to get strong turnout in order to do it. For the president, he needs to replicate that 2016 map. So let me show you hypothetically. If he were to hang on to Florida, hang on to Georgia, like he won it last time, get North Carolina, and pull out Ohio and, let's say, Iowa. Okay, now he gets a little closer to Joe Biden's number, and now we're back through the Upper Midwest again. This is where Tony's done that road trip, right? That's why these states are so important. And then the president would have to go flip, say, a Pennsylvania, maybe Wisconsin again, to get him back over the top. All hypothetical, but that's the kind of dynamic that we're going to watch on election night and see what happens, Anthony.
Anthony, you've been making calls for 10 years on election night. How is this year going to be different?
Yeah, it's not getting any easier, Anthony, I'll tell you that. But, you know, this year is going to be different because there's so much early vote. And as you all have reported so well, there's so many people who are casting ballots early, casting ballots by mail, and also some of the states may be slower in counting. What that means for us on election night is that we are going to be completely transparent with everybody, show you what we know and show you what we don't. And as soon as the polls close, what I'm going to do is take all the data that we have, our exit polling, our vote models, which combine all the trends and patterns that we see, and we're going to show you which way a state is leaning or which way it's likely to go, even before we can project it. And in that way, we're going to give you a comprehensive picture of what's going on, so that as the votes come in, you'll see it the same way our decision desk sees it in real time, Anthony.
Anthony, 4 years ago, obviously the outcome was not what the polls suggested before the election. A lot of people are suspicious. Do you think we could have something like that happen this time around?
Everything about that comes down to turnout. And I know that can sound sometimes like a cliche, but a poll will tell you what people are thinking. And then what do they actually do? Well, this year we've got a really interesting dynamic, Anthony. Let me show you this. Take a few key states. People who have already voted tell us that they're favoring Joe Biden. We've got strong numbers, Florida, Georgia, North Carolina, that early vote trending his way. But if we talk to people who haven't voted yet, they tell us they're leaning towards the president. So what does that mean? We'll get to election night. We might say that Joe Biden has a lead in what's already cast in these states. And then do the president's supporters, like they did in 2016, turn out in large numbers, large enough to swing those states back to the president? It's that turnout dynamic that we're going to watch so carefully.
Anthony, quickly, are you expecting a result on election night? Will we know who the next president is?
I'm going to give you a solid maybe, Anthony. A solid maybe.
That's what I was expecting.
But Anthony, are you leaning toward a maybe yes or a maybe no? Everything.
It's a lean maybe, gal.
It's a lean.
We're going to say a lean maybe.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah. Tune in. It's going to be great, and we're going to stay with it. We're going to stay with it as long as it takes.
Yes, we will.
We certainly are. All right, Anthony Salvanto, thanks so much for taking us through all that.